cuff deflation. Cuff deflation should be done slowly following oral care, oral suctioning, and tracheal suctioning as needed. Without airflow through the oropharynx, sensation may be reduced and secretions may have accumulated to the top of the tracheostomy tube cuff, making it difficult for patients to adjust to a deflated cuff. To deflate the cuff, first obtain the provided syringe. Remove all air from the syringe by pushing the plunger in completely. Attach the tip or hub of the syringe into the needle valve of the pilot balloon. Then pull back slowly on the plunger of the syringe. Make sure the tip of the syringe stays securely inserted into the needle valve. Continue slowly pulling back on the plunger until resistance is met. At this point, the pilot balloon should now appear empty and flat. Next, remove the syringe, push the plunger of the syringe to remove air from the syringe, and reattach the empty syringe to the pilot balloon needle valve. Pull back on the syringe until resistance is felt and no more air can be removed to assure the cuff is completely deflated. If the cuff is being deflated to assess the upper airway for the use of the no-leak passy-muir valve, the cuff of the tracheostomy tube must be completely deflated.